Hi guys, welcome back to TattyXO. Today's just a quick video and I'm just going to be talking you through a few of my favourite makeup brushes that I have in my collection at the moment. I am buying a few bits and bobs now and again to add to the collection, but I thought it would just be useful to go through the ones that I'm enjoying using. So I've got my little candle holder from M&S here. It did have a candle in, and I've just thought I'd reuse it as a makeup brush holder, and so I'm just going to be talking to each one of these brushes with you and telling you why I like it and why you should think about buying it and adding it to your collection. I hope you enjoy it and I hope it's insightful and useful, particularly if you're looking to buy some new makeup brushes soon. So the first makeup brush is just a powder brush. It looks really nice. I love the rose gold finish. It's got some nice soft bristles. This is actually from H&M and I think it cost me about £5.99 or something like that. And these are great even as stocking fillers if you want to get your friends some makeup brushes and things like that. What I really like about this brush is once I've actually finished doing my powders and my blusher and my bronzer, I can just really blend it in and just make sure everything's all nice and blended when I'm finishing my makeup before I add my setting spray. I love how soft the bristles are. When I wash it, the bristles don't fall out, and that's a big deal for me because I've had some makeup brushes and the bristles just come out, even when I've been making sure not to get water up where that joins to the handle. It's lovely and small. It can fit in a travel bag as well. And you know, for £5.99, what do you want? You just want a makeup brush that's cheap, that blends your makeup in, and you can bring it with you if you are out and about. So for me, that's definitely one of my favourites in my collection. I've got another sort of a blender brush to show you. This time it's from Ecotools. So this is what it looks like. So it's almost like a rectangular boxed brush, a kabuki brush. Some people I've seen use this almost like to do the contour blending when they've got a bronzer on, but I usually just sort of turn it sideways and just double check that the contour and blush is actually sort of blended as well, similar to this one, but I do also sometimes just go off over my face, whereas I usually use this one over my cheeks. I believe this was about £7, but for any of the brushes, wherever I can, I'll leave the links down below and that will have the prices and things like that and where you can buy it from. The bristles feel lovely and soft. Again, I've not seen any fallout when I've been washing the brush and sort of cleaning it with makeup shampoo. And I do quite like Ecotools. This was the first brush I ever bought from them, and so far I've been really enjoying using it, so I'm going to look at maybe getting a few more bits and pieces from them. So I have mentioned this brush to you before in my November hits and misses video, but I'm loving it. This is a Real Techniques blusher brush. This is what it looks like when it focuses. This blusher brush is absolutely fantastic. It blends my blusher in so well, and I don't even have to go at it for ages. A couple of swoops and it's just perfectly blended, and I'm often reaching for this over some of my more expensive makeup brushes. I think this was £10 or less, probably £9.99, but I will double check. The handle is lovely and easy to hold, got a nice grip to it. The bristles again haven't fallen out, and they just feel so soft, and I love how it's almost sort of contoured and pointed just to make sure that it sort of really reaches your cheeks on that perfect blending angle. If you've not got this blusher brush or you've never tried Real Techniques, then you should definitely go ahead and buy this brush because it's absolutely amazing. And like I've said before, Real Techniques often have gift sets with more than one brush in it. So if you're sort of making Christmas lists or you want to get someone a gift, then get one of those Real Techniques sort of gift sets, and then you've got maybe four or five brushes to start you out. I'm really enjoying using it. I love the girly pink colour, and yeah, you should definitely look into getting this one. So the next brush is a brush that I got as part of the Bare Minerals starter set, which you can get from loads of places like Debenhams and things like that. I think it was about £35, but it basically came with some starter bare minerals foundations and powders, like the mineral veil and sort of two shades of foundation, and three brushes. So one was a concealer brush, one looked like a sort of a blusher brush, and then this powder brush here. I actually use this for bronzer or blusher, but I have used it before as like a powder brush, and it's just amazing for really sort of just blending it in again, and just making sure that there are no streaks. Sometimes I think people are really sort of nervous to use sort of bronzer because sometimes it just doesn't blend in. Well, what I will say is, as well as getting a decent quality product, the brush has to be a decent quality as well to really make sure that blends in. I've had some sort of cheapo sort of bronzer and blusher brushes. I've used it with a really good quality bronzer, but it's actually made it go on patchy, and that was because of the brush. Whereas this brush is amazing. It really does just blend in really, really nice. It feels soft on my face. And again, like, I'm not seeing any fallout when I'm washing it, and it's just a really nice size as well, like that could definitely fit in a travel makeup bag as well. But you can buy bare minerals brushes on their own, it doesn't have to be as part of a kit or anything like that. So the next brush is a concealer brush, and this one is from Vital Radiance, and it's quite a thin pointed end. And I use this usually to sort of line below my brows, because although you've added on your pomade or your powder or whatever you want to do to fill in your brows, I really like to neaten it up. And this brush is fantastic because it's so precise. In addition to that, for the same sort of use, I also really like the MAC 212 brush, which is this lovely sort of rectangular ended brush. Which again just really makes that line really nice and precise. I also like to use this 212 brush as well if I'm doing like a cut crease, to just sort of add my cream shadow before I put the shadow on top, and it really carves out the crease shape that you're looking to achieve. So those two brushes are excellent, and I think that Vital Radiance one cost me like less than £5, so I will double check and I'll leave the links down below. The next brush is a buffer brush, and this one is from Makeup Geek. This is a face brusher brush. This is what it looks like, the face buffer brush. And what I use this brush for is when I'm doing sort of a cream contour and I put my lines all over my face and my nose and my jawline, this brush just sort of blends it in and carves it out and really just make sure that it's streak free. I usually do it for quite a while just to double check and just make sure that it's definitely blended in. But I really like this, and it's a lot better than some of the other buffer brushes that I tried prior to this. I did have to ship this one from the Makeup Geek website, but I think that there are actually more and more websites in the UK where you can actually buy sort of Makeup Geek products. So I'll have a browse and I'll put the link down below. This is just fantastic for a cream contour. It's really nice. I think I've seen a few other people as well just use it to blend in foundation, which would work just as good. The next brush is again from Real Techniques. It actually looks like a miniature version of that blusher brush that I showed you before. But this is actually the Real Techniques setting brush. I actually use this as a highlighter brush. Before I sort of apply it, I give a couple of swoops in there, a highlighter, and then a couple of swoops over my cheeks. I don't have to take extra care to make sure that it applies evenly, because the brush pretty much does the job for you. And it just applies it really nice and blended as well. I've had some sort of highlighter brushes that have just sort of clumped it on. Whereas this just applies really nicely. Again, you can use it sort of on your cupid's bow or on the tip of your nose if you want to add highlight there. And it's just really nice. Again, it's a lovely size. It's so nice and light. The grip when I'm holding it is just fantastic. I love the girly pink colour. And you know, Real Techniques are really affordable. Even if you're on a budget, you can afford decent quality makeup brushes. So have a look on that link down below that I'll leave you. and just go and check them out. You can also read reviews for yourself online from other websites. And believe me, you won't be disappointed if you do decide to invest in some Real Techniques brushes. So the next brush, and again I mentioned this one before, is the NYX Professional Makeup Brush number 16, and this is the Pro Crease Blender Brush. In addition to that, my favourite ever MAC brush is the MAC 224 brush, which is just fantastic for blending in on the crease of my eye. Now the reason that I'm showing these two together is that they're just fantastic for blending in eyeshadows, not even necessarily on the crease line, but even in the under eye blend. You know, if you can't necessarily afford the MAC brush at the minute, this NYX one, I think it cost me £9, again I'll double check, is fantastic. It's just as good as the MAC. The bristles are super soft, both of them are just a joy to wash, and the product comes out lovely and it doesn't sort of make the brushes bristles greasy or anything like that. And I think if you're like me and you often apply a lot of eyeshadows and certainly sort of love to add a smoky eye, then you need to get both or at least one of these to add to your collection, because it just did apply flawlessly. And if I'm ever traveling, I would not leave without these brushes. They're incredible. And you know, you can never have too many sort of blender or crease brushes in your life, because the key to applying a nice eyeshadow is just blending it and making sure it just looks flawless. So yeah, I'll leave the links for those down below. I looked for an angled liner brush for absolutely ages, and now I'm seeing it everywhere. But the one that I bought was the Inglot 30T brush, which is this lovely angled eyeliner brush, which is just really, really easy to use. It's still got a little bit of product on from when I used it this morning, but it's really, really precise. And it's fantastic for adding a wing as well. I'm terrible at doing eyeliner. I usually do it perfectly on one eye, and then on the other eye it's not so great. Or sometimes I'm just having an off day and neither goes right. But I found that with this sort of angled brush, it just helps you get a sort of a better application than some of the sort of just normal thin eyeliner brushes that I've used. I don't just stick to this one. I do have a thin sort of MAC liner brush that I like to use just when I really want a teeny bit of just eyeliner on the top of my eyelid. But this Inglot one, I really like it if I want a thicker wing, or even without a wing. Sometimes I just like to line my eye right up into that corner. It's just really, really nice. And I think this cost me about £11 as well. So again, you're not going to be breaking the bank. I do believe that NYX do have a wing liner brush as well, so have a look on the website as well if you're looking at those other brushes that I showed you. But Inglot have some fantastic things. I also really like to use this with the Inglot number 66 gel eyeliner, which is amazing. It's probably the blackest sort of black gel liner that I've used. And it's just amazing. It lashes for absolutely ages. The pot's really nice, and if you pair it with this brush, you won't be disappointed if you're a fan of eyeliner. Last three brushes. So again, I told you before that you can never have too many sort of blending brushes. I've just sort of shopped on eBay for some really cheap, quick and easy brush sets. Not all of the brushes in it were great. I didn't really like the foundation brushes because the bristles came out. But I did get quite a few of these sort of angled sort of blender brushes when it focuses. And you can get them for, I think it was for like less than £5 for a full set. So I did get quite a few of these. And these bristles feel really, really nice and soft. They're actually really easy to wash. Just be careful sort of with that metal end, don't get water near it, because I think that's probably what I did with the foundation brush and why the bristles came out. Just really sort of focus on the end and just twirl it around to clean it. But again, they just blend my eyeshadows really nice as well, and because I use quite a lot of different colours, you know, you can get one of these sets and then you're sorted ready for all your different colours that you want to apply. So just get looking on places like eBay. It's often free shipping as well, so it's a nice quick and easy fix if you need some quick brushes and just to add to your collection, or if any of your other brushes have damaged or what have you. Last two brushes. So you know that I love my foundations, and I wanted a really nice sort of brush to just blend it in. Sometimes I use sort of a beauty blender, and we do have a Real Techniques one, which is amazing. But I really like the number 130 brush from MAC. So this is like a stippling brush, and it's smaller than what you probably would have expected. But I just really like to use this to sort of blend my foundation, because I can just go at it sort of area to area, whereas if I've got a big brush, I use it to sort of scrub it all over my face, where I like to just sort of take my time sometimes. And it applies my foundation flawlessly, not even just with the MAC Studio Fix foundation that I have, but also with some of my other ones, even, you know, my amazing Urban Decay Naked foundation, the daytime one. It just applies really, really well, and I just think if you wear foundation a lot, you want to make sure that you're getting a brush that blends it, that doesn't leave a line, and you know, that doesn't leave sort of remnants or ripples of foundation on your skin. So I'd definitely look at investing in a stippling brush. Doesn't even have to be MAC, but this is the one that I've been using, and it's just my go-to foundation brush at the minute. It's just amazing. Final brush, again from MAC. I do have a lot of MAC brushes, but I have been trying some other brands recently as well. This is a number 227 brush, and I just love this brush, particularly for when I've got a cut crease and I just really want to make sure it's all blended. This brush is just amazing. It's really, really nice and soft. It's huge, it's thick. Sometimes I even use it just to sort of set a clear or white powder on my eye before I start doing other shadows, just like apply it on top of an eyeshadow primer. But it's just really good for just sort of adding an extra bit of blend as well once you've almost finished your eyeshadows. But I will leave the link down below if you want to look at getting this one. It is amazing. It's just so nice and thick as well. So that's all the brushes I had to show you. It's just sort of a quick and easy sort of step. Ugh. Okay, so that's all the brushes I had to show you. This was just a nice and quick, easy video for you guys to watch, and hopefully it's been insightful for you to hear a few of the makeup brushes that I've been really enjoying using at the minute. I'd love for you to get in touch and tell me if you've got any recommendations yourselves, or if have you had any sort of different experiences with these brushes. Either get in touch with the comment section down below or on any of my social media channels, which I'll leave the links to down below as well. Or even just sort of send me an email via my blog or something like that. I'd really love to hear from you guys. Hope you've enjoyed it, and enjoy the rest of your day. I'll be getting a new video out very soon.